more of an unsolved mystery and less of a true crime. But there is some crime involved, so if you're into true crime and unsolved mystery, ASMR, definitely subscribe to my channel and give me a like. I really, really appreciate it. It means the world to me. Okay, so today, if you didn't already see in the title, this was such a weird case that I looked into because it could, like, literally be any of the theories. Like, no one knows for sure what actually happened, so I'm really excited to get into it. Now, if you don't like this type, there's, it's not a super brutal case, but there is, like, murder and death involved, so if you don't like that, that are relaxing. And there are other creators that just create, like, very peaceful, relaxing, non-murder-esque ASMR. But if you're into that, then you have come to the right place. So let's get started. Also, just a little disclaimer. I do have my notes. I did research and I took notes from different podcasts and Reddit and the internet, different websites. And they're over here. It is not memorized in my head, so if you see me looking off camera, it's because I'm scrolling through a Word document I have. Okay, so, the ISDAL woman, is just a name given to this lady because they never found any records on her at all. They could never find who her family was or her real name. So she was found dead at Isdalen or Ice Valley in, I'm gonna butcher these names because this is a foreign case, in Bergen, Norway, on November 29th, 1970. So we're in the 70s. Although police at the time, they ruled it a suicide, there's different theories as to why it's not. So on the afternoon of November 29th, 1970, a man and his two daughters were hiking in the Ice Valley. Or it was also called Death Valley, on the north face of Ulriken in Bergen, Norway. It's called Death Valley because in the Middle Ages there's a history of suicides, which is pretty sad. So they were hiking and they start to notice, like, a burning smell or a burnt smell, and they said it kind of, like, smelled like barbecue. So they were walking along and they decided to follow the smells for whatever reason. And they found the ISDAL woman's burnt, charred body kind of, like, in the rocks at the bottom of this canyon. Oh, they returned to the town to notify the police, and the police arrived shortly after. Did all, like, the evidence and looking at what position she was in and what was around the body. So, they noticed that her clenched hands were up by her torso, and there was an absence of a nearby campfire anywhere. However, they did find a petrol can. Full of petrol. So, the front of her body had been burned. They found her lying in, like, a bunch of rocks. The front of her body had been completely burned, and her back wasn't as burned at all, which is pretty weird. And she was very unrecognizable, so there was, like, no features they could go off of. So also, near her, and it was kind of odd because they noticed that these objects weren't just, like, scattered around. They had been consciously, like, placed down next to her and near her. So, like, bracelets, the items that they had found were an empty bottle of liquor, two plastic water bottles, a plastic passport container, rubber boots, and the blue rubber boots are important, rubber boots, a woolen jumper, a scarf, nylon stockings, an umbrella, a purse, a matchbox, a watch, two earrings, and a ring. That is, like, such a random assortment of things, especially probably go hiking. So she had all that in a random area. Around the body, there were traces of burned paper, and beneath it, a fur hat, which they later found had traces of petrol on it. And it was also weird because all identifying marks, like brands or labels on clothes and these items had been rubbed off or cut off. So you couldn't tell, like, where the brand came from, what even the brand was. They had all been either rubbed or destroyed or cut off, which is really strange. So, 3 days later, at a railway station, investigators found two suitcases belonging to the woman, and they knew it belonged to her because they had matched. There were glasses, I think either on or near the suitcases, and they matched her fingerprint to a fingerprint they had found on the lens of the glasses, which is pretty cool. So inside the suitcases is what is really strange. They found 100 Deutschmark notes, which is just the old German money. So it was about $130 in 1970s time. So among other items, they found clothing, shoes, wigs, combs, makeup, and eczema cream, and also different money from different countries, maps, timetables, that pair of glasses, sunglasses, cosmetics, and a notepad. And they also found a little piece of paper with writing on it that I'll get into, but I wanted to go back to the eczema cream and all the different stuff they found. So inside of her suitcase, nothing had a brand name, and all of the labels had also been destroyed. So on makeup, you couldn't tell what the makeup was. It was the same thing as what had been found on her body. So that kind of shows that it wasn't a second party that had destroyed her labels. Some people kind of theorized, oh, well, maybe people destroyed the labels to make sure it's like untrackable, she's untrackable. But actually, I think that would mean that she herself destroyed the labels because all of her belongings didn't have any brands. So, going back to that little piece of paper, it also had a bunch of little writing on it, so the police thought it was kind of a code. As well as the eczema cream didn't have, it was a prescription eczema cream, so it didn't have her name on it or her doctor's name. That had been all rubbed off. So, keep the little piece of paper in your mind, the little with like the weird little writing on it. So, in her autopsy, the autopsy concluded that she had died from a number of things. So, they found it said phenobarbital, but I think that's just a medication. It's a sleeping pill medication, and they found about 50 to 70 pills in her stomach. That is so many pills. But they also noted that it hadn't been fully absorbed in her bloodstream, so it wasn't like the main cause of death, but it was mostly poisoning by carbon monoxide was her cause of death, with a touch of medication overdose. Soot was also found in her lungs, which means that she was alive as she was burning, because she was inhaling and breathing in the ash of her own body. They also found a really bad neck on a bruise on her neck, which could have been from the fall or a blow from someone. Analysis of her blood showed that she had consumed anywhere from 50 to 70 sleeping pills, which is a ton. Also, at her autopsy, her teeth and her jaw were removed because she had really unique dental work that she had a bunch of gold fillings that could be identified in different areas and could show like where she got those, that dental work done in Europe. So, going back to what was in her suitcase, they found a plastic bag with a shoe store on it, and the shoe store was 130 miles away from where the body had been found. So they went to the shoe store and they showed or asked the store owner if he had sold anyone the pair of blue boots that they had also found at the crime scene or at the scene of her death. The shoe store owner said yes, he remembers selling the blue boots to a woman who was dressed nicely and had long brown hair. She had a round face and brown eyes, and also remembered that she smelled like garlic, which is a weird fact, but that's what he said. The police used this description to track a hotel that the ISDAL woman was staying at under the name of Vanilla Lorch. However, this was not her real name, they later realized, and she actually used 8 different names. Different hotels in Norway. This means she had multiple passports with multiple names and multiple identities. So police were able to match up the names by using a handwriting analysis, the hotel check-in and forms, and cross-reference it with the codes they found on that little piece of paper. So the codes on the little piece of paper corresponded to the hotels and the dates she stayed at the hotels and the places she stayed at. Which is interesting. So just kind of weird. She has wigs and different types of clothing and 8 different names and like 8 different passports, and she's also using like codes. So it's something called like conspiracy. It's called conspiracy behavior. So just weird. Also, something I thought that was interesting that I read or I saw in a video about this case is that they took her dental records and a professor was doing analysis on them, and the professor found that she's most likely got her fillings from southern to central Europe, so like Spain or Germany or France or even possibly Asia. But before she could pinpoint a location of where the ISDAL woman got the fillings, they died. And then the teeth and the jaw accidentally got thrown out because they were getting too smelly. So I actually saw this, the only place I saw that fact was a BuzzFeed video. So I don't know how accurate that is, but I just thought that was funny and thought I would throw it in. That someone just was like, oh, these teeth are getting smelly. Okay, let's just get rid of them. That is something I would do. Maybe not if I knew I was working with crime scene evidence, but if like something is gross or something is dirty, I'm like, just get rid of it. Like, ew. Samples of her like heart and tissue. It was really weird. So they found the teeth, and this is like maybe 20 or 30 years later when they're doing tests on the teeth, like modern day tests. We're not in the 80s anymore. So they're doing modern day, it's called the isotope test, or they're able to test the teeth and get a reading on like what water she drank, and from what water she drank, pinpoint where she lived or where she grew up, and they figured out, they were able to pinpoint a little border area near France and Germany, which is interesting, I guess. So the police, and based off of all this evidence, they couldn't find any suspects, and they couldn't find anyone that could possibly have murdered her. So they ruled it as a suicide. Of course they did. They ruled it as a suicide. But I wanted to go into different theories because so many people don't believe it's a suicide. Also, there were police on the case that don't even believe it was a suicide. But, I mean, what are you supposed to do? But it's also weird because why would you want to take all the pills and then set yourself on fire? Like, if I was going to... pass peacefully and, you know, fall asleep, not go out the worst way possible, cover myself in petrol, and light her up. I don't think so. So suicide is for me. So theory two is that it was an accident. Like, she was at the top of the cliff and she had a campfire and she accidentally caught on fire because it was just her front that was on fire. So she jumped backwards to get away from the flames and fell off the cliff. But then it doesn't explain the petrol that was found at where she was found. So petrol was also found where she was found. So that doesn't really, that one's not good, not a good theory. Another theory is that she was a spy and she was murdered in some espionage cover up. Due to all the weird quirks. So a lot of people think that she was a spy and she was running away or she was a part of the KGB. But then some people were saying, why would you make that if she was actually part of the espionage, like, ring or whatever, if she was actually was a spy, why would you make it that, like, obvious? Like, people, spies are professionals. They're not gonna just leave a burnt body at the bottom of a cliff with pills shoved down their throats. Like, no, there were too many loose ends. And then the last theory is that she just was murdered. She just straight up murdered. Like, just plain old murder. Someone just wanted her dead. So the police explain it as conspiratory behavior. She's running. She has wigs, coats, and passports. She's going to, like, 8 different hotels, running away, changing her name. So those are big points to that point to murder. So that is the case of the ISDAL woman. It's really weird. They never figured out her name or anything. It was kind of a short one. There weren't as many, there were 0 suspects to go over. But if you have any conspiracies or think of anything about the ISDAL woman, let me know in the comments. There's also a really good podcast you can watch or listen to. I think it's BBC, that really goes over all of the theories in more detail. And it was really, really interesting to listen to. But that's the end. I'm going to be creating more true crime because I love true crime, but also maybe some basic ASMR, cut and dry, tingles and tapping, and less murdery and scary, especially since we're getting closer to Christmas.